Hey guys, thanks a lot for joining me today. Welcome back to the channel. Today you join me at Big City Jack's recording studio for a specific reason. I'm going to be looking at the Lauten Audio Tom Mic as well as the Lauten Audio Snare Mic. We're going to see how they sound, what the build quality is like, and how they work in a mix. So join me and let's go and have a look. Okay, so on the snare top, we've got the Beta 57A and we've got the Lauten snare mic. Now, if you look at the positioning, the Beta 57 is a lot lower than the Lauten, and the reason for that is because the Lauten is a large diaphragm condenser, which means it picks up a hell of a lot of frequency range, whereas the Shure Beta 57A is a dynamic. This captures a lot clearer of a picture, the Lauten. Now, if you look, I'm aiming roughly towards the centre of the drum, and with the Beta 57 I'm about, give or take, 2 fingers in height off the top of the drum, whereas with the Lauten I'm closer to 3 fingers up, maybe a little bit more, and that is aiming more across the face of the drum rather than being directly at the middle. If you aim the Lauten directly at the middle, you're going to pick up a lot of low end and not so much top end, whereas if you go across the face of the drum you get a really balanced picture of the snare. So moving across to the floor tom. When I came in today, I was tracking with it for the first time, and so I played around with positioning and I found this ended up being my favourite. As you can see, I'm a few inches in from the rim of the drum and probably maybe 4 fingers up, aiming sort of down, not across the face of the drum. I found that if you aim across the face of the drum, what you end up getting is quite a lot of bleed from other mics, and you don't gain that much in terms of clarity of the tom. If you aim down slightly, you get a really nice mixture of stick attack and body, but you get quite a lot of rejection from the other instruments as well. Moving up to the rack tom, you can see that in a very similar pattern to the floor tom, we've got it about 4 fingers away, and it's aiming a few inches in from the rim of the drum. Again, I found similarly when I was playing around with the position of the microphone, if you aim it across the drum like you do with the snare mic, you get a lot of bleed and you don't really gain much in terms of clarity. So for me, this is about the best position to have it in. You get a lot of body in the drum, but you get a really nice stick attack as well. All right, so we're going to be taking a look in the Lauten Audio microphone boxes to see what you get. On the outside of the box, you actually have a graphic which shows you the pickup pattern of the microphone. And you also have a life-size decal of how big the actual mic is. Opening up the box, you're confronted by a couple of things. You have a card in there which tells you everything about the microphone and what it does. A cool feature is you actually get a tom towel inside, or at least what I believe to be a tom towel, which has a nice graphic on it, and that can be draped over the toms for the purposes of deadening them, which is cool. You get one of them in every box as well, which is nice. Now, the actual microphone itself, you get a nice sort of padded pouch. It kind of feels a bit like neoprene, like a wetsuit on the inside, which is nice. And then you reveal the actual microphone. Over the back, you've got just a protective cover, which protects the microphone mount. Now, on the microphone itself, as you can see, you've got a couple of options. The first option being a high pass filter. So you can either have this set to flat 80 Hertz or 140 Hertz. And then you also have a low pass filter, which you can roll off at 5K or 12K. In the case of the recording, I've actually got both of these set flat. So bear that in mind when you're listening back to the samples. Now, moving on, Let's put that to one side and let's have a look at the snare mic. Now again, you've got a nice decal on the front which tells you the exact size of the microphone, and you've also got, same again, with the pickup pattern on the side, for those of you that are interested in that kind of thing. Now, opening up the snare box, we are confronted with the same thing. We get another drum towel, which I assume would be, on this basis, used for snares, or you could use it as a flag for the wall. You do you. Inside, you get the same neoprene soft case, and it's a very similar setup for this mic. Again, you've got the cover, which is going to cover the microphone mount, and on this microphone, you have exactly the same options. You've either got 80 Hz or 140 Hz as a roll-off, or you've got 5K or 12K. Now, in the purpose of this example, again, the low pass is actually flat, but on this one, I've set the high pass to 140 Hz. And that was because when I was testing and flicking around, I was getting quite a lot of low end pickup off the snare, because the snare I'm using is a 14x8 recording custom. It has a hell of a lot of low end in it. And even with the roll off set to 140, I've still got tons of body in there, which you'll hear in a minute when we get into listening to the direct tracks. Let's jump into Pro Tools and I'll show you what they sound like. So let's jump right in. So here's what we've got so far. All right, cool, let's solo the drums up. All right, first things first. I'm not gonna go through the whole drum mixing tutorial here because we're really just focusing on the Lauten mics. So let me take the processing that I've got off the snare top and I'll talk you through what I did. So, okay, so that was what was captured raw. First things first, I've got trigger. Now, trigger's only acting as a gate. That's all that's doing. There's no sample replacement going on. Next, we've got Electro DSP, which is boosting some high-end. Now, for any of you that are familiar with the Electro EQ, I know it's saying it's boosting from 3K, but it's actually, the slope's a lot steeper than that, so it's hitting more up into like 10, 12. We're boosting a little bit of 2K. Let's have a listen to how that sounds. As you can hear, it's just bringing out a little bit of flavour, a little bit of crack, and that is cool. After that, we've got a Pro Q, because there was a little ringing frequency I wanted to get rid of. That bad boy. I'm also boosting a little more low end, a little more top end. I thought, more is more, right? If I bypass this, I like a big thick snare, so sometimes I boost a lot of that. Next, we have got a 260 VU or DBX 160. Now, I am using a hardware one here, but for the purposes of this demonstration, what I'm actually going to do is stick a software one on, and I'll get the same settings. That's exactly about where I'm going. The next thing is a tube drive, which is giving it a little bit of saturation, but we can do this with Saturn as well. Now, we've also got the Beta 57 here. Now, the Beta 57 is going through very similar treatment. we're all familiar with the Beta 57, right? So we've got the same gate, we've got exactly the same EQs going on, and this one's got an 1176 on it. Now we're using a Shure Unidyne 3 on the snare bottom. Nice and crispy sounding. Blend them together. Alright, let's have a look at the toms. So, again, I'm using outboard here, but I can substitute that with a plug-in, so that's fine. First things first, we're doing a little bit with Saturn. I'm adding just a tiny bit of drive, but the important thing here is the dynamics control. So anybody that's seen any of Nolly's mixing techniques will know where this trick comes from. So if you listen to this bypassed on both, and that's what the raw mics sound like. And then of course, we put it in and it kind of acts like a gate. Again without. Just tightens them up a little bit. Now EQ, this is my standard sort of tom processing. I would usually do this on an SSL if I was working on an actual client song, as it were, but for the purposes of this demonstration, and if I'm being completely honest, wanting to get it done quickly, I did it visually with Pro-Q. So as you can see, I'm just raising a little bit of low end around the fundamental, sucking out all them nasty ass mids, and boosting a bunch of top where the stick attack is. Same goes for the floor. And then if we stick the 76s on as well, something along them lines, we have. I mean, they just sound absolutely phenomenal. The thing that I found with these microphones is they're really, really quite versatile, and you can push them quite a long way with EQ without them collapsing completely. These always remain sounding really good. Let's have a listen to the actual samples of the soloed microphones. So if I get all of this in here, and let's bypass everything that's going on. Bypass all that, right, so we're just back to raw mics. So first up we've got the snare, so if I put that all in, now if we listen to just the Lauten, I mean, that captures a hell of a lot of body and a really nice top end. They're beautiful sounding microphones. Next, let's move on to the rack tom and see what the rack mic sounds like. as you can hear, there's a ton of body in that. It's got a nice stick attack, it's got a really nice kind of character to it, and as I said before, it takes EQ really well. Let's move on to the floor. Again, absolutely beautiful sounding microphone, really captures the low end in the floor tom and also captures that nice kind of stick attack. Let's jump out and I'll talk some more about them. So thanks a lot for joining me on this journey of discovery with the Lauten Tom mics and the Lauten snare mics. Leave some comments down below with what you think of them and if you're going to be getting them for your studio or drum space. I personally absolutely love these microphones. They are the kind of thing I've been looking for years. They just sound so good. The rejection is very, very good. Do you get bleed from other sources on the kit? Yes, you do, but if you consider against like a 421 or a 57 or something, it's like 25 dB lower. It's completely manageable, which makes it a lot easier to gate things out. There's not complete rejection, but then again, that could be down to my placement. This was the first time I've ever used the microphones, and I think over time I will learn more about the best place to put them. I think I got a pretty good result. I'm pleased with how the drums came out, and I'm going to really look forward to using them in the future and beyond, because I don't see myself ever needing another Tom microphone. They just sound so good. So hats off to Lauten. You've done a really, really great job with these. And for the price point, which is in the UK £399 per microphone, is unbeatable value for what you get. So the new Lauten Audio Tom mic and the snare mic, which has been around for a while, go out and grab yours. I'll leave a link in the description box below to Lauten's website where you can find out some more information. Thanks a lot for joining me today, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please consider doing so. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.